Hello, Davis. Today is February 21st. Do you know what day is today? It's International Mother Language Day. Many people commented me, can you make this? Actually, it's not a famous day in Korea. So honestly, I didn't know either. In Korea, we celebrate Hangul Day, October 9th, instead of this. It's the day Hangul alphabet was created by King Sejong. Let's look at this. The statue of King Sejong, it's located in Gwanghwamun Plaza in central Seoul. And you can see him in 10,000 won too. Yes, it's him. I'm rich. He is number one respected person in Korea with General Lee Sun-shin. So as you can see, Koreans are really proud of their own language. So I was interested in this topic, International Mother Language Day. So where does this come from? Let's see. At first, UNESCO made this day in 1999. But why did they make that? I will tell you about the background. It's really interesting. The story has come from Bangladesh. Last time I talked about why Pakistan and Bangladesh were separated. Actually, there were so many complex reasons that I even couldn't understand. But the beginning was language. After Pakistan separated from India, Pakistan and Bangladesh was one country. But Pakistan forced Bangladesh use Urdu, not their own language, Bengali. But of course, Bangladesh didn't accept that. They fought to keep their language. Finally, a massive protest happened in Bangladesh. Many people, including university students in Bangladesh, fought for their language. And sadly, some of them were sacrificed while the protest. But because of this sacrifice, they could use their language again. So that's why UNESCO made this day to remember them. Yeah, it's really impressive. I think language is not just language. Each language has their own story, culture, and spirit of people. So make them stop to speak their own language. It's like stealing the person's soul. Actually, Koreans also couldn't use our own language for a while. After Korea became a Japanese colony, we couldn't use our language. School taught students in Japanese, and even every Korean should change their name to Japanese. Like Doraemon Kim or Naruto Kim. Naruto Kim? It's good. Korean newspaper company closed, and many Korean language scholars, poets, or novelists went to jail because they struggled to keep Hangul against them. For example, the best poet of Korean history, Yoon Dong-ju. He died just before Korea's independence. But because of their efforts, Korea can protect our own language, like Bangladesh. We are similar at that point. Maybe we should be brother country too. Anyway, the language has people's history, culture, spirit, pride, and even their identity. It's that important. That's why we fought for that. So I'm really proud that our ancestor kept our Hangul, like Bangladesh. When I was young, I wanted that Korea use English because I didn't want to study. But now I like that we have our own language. Good. According to UNESCO, there are at least 7,000 languages in the world. But they guessed more than half of language will disappear in a few decades. I think if the language disappears, the memories of people also disappear. So I hope people love and keep their own language, even if it's a minority language. Yeah, I really want that. So I'm done. What language do you use? And do you love that?